for making it to the cover page of this amazing magazine. I think that gathered in this room this evening are business owners and CEOs, and what I want to leave with us is for us to continue to anticipate the needs of our customers. That's the only way we'll continue to remain relevant. Thank you.
It's a pleasure to welcome all of you to this momentous, the launch of the award issue of the EMY Africa magazine. On behalf of the board, the faculty, and the entire EMY Africa organization, I'd like to thank all of you for taking time off your busy schedule to join us this evening to celebrate this very important issue. At EMY Africa, our goal is to project a new and a positive African narrative by celebrating African excellence and, you know, Africans who are doing very well in the diaspora.
Friday, the 5th day of April 2024, history is made, and we count now from 3, 2, 1. It's official, ladies and gentlemen. The awards issue has been launched, and this is a testament and a masterpiece filled with greatness to inspire you to reach your highest potential. And of course, the cover page is the reigning champion, the man of the year for the 8th EMY Africa Awards for the year 2023, Mr. sometime tonight.
Celebrate
greatness.
All together.
It's a whole life to have all our great personalities here as we do a very nice group picture. Thank you so much. You'll find this in the newspapers on Monday morning. Congratulations, EMY Africa magazine, for this excellent launch of the awards issue. Thank you so much. So please, take your seats, and we'll have the man of the year and the woman of the year. Please stay behind everyone else. Can see our remarks from the woman of the year and the man of the year. As tradition demands, ladies first.
Man of the year for making it to the cover page of this amazing magazine. I think that gathered in this room this evening are business owners and CEOs and. What I want to leave with us is for us to continue to anticipate the needs of our customers. That's the only way we'll continue to remain relevant. Thank you.
A few things down since I do about 10 speeches a week. Sometimes I don't know which audience I'm speaking to. I might be speaking about investment or something here. But there we are. Thank you very much. Congratulations, Woman of the Year, distinguished invited guest, our friends of the media, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome you all to KGL Hub, all the KGL group. Let me first of all begin by thanking Kojo and the entire EMY group for this fantastic event. They deserve our commendation for the caliber of events we put together. Distinguished guests, accepting this mantle of the Man of the Year has offered me the platform to articulate my views and vision as one of the leaders of corporate Ghana. It is a vision to redefine the concept of wealth as a vehicle for socio-economic transformation of our nation and continent, leaving a legacy, a lasting legacy of shared prosperity for all Ghanaians. This also informed the setting up of the KGL Foundation, the corporate social responsibility arm of the KGL, which continues to provide substantial resources in the area of education, health, youth empowerment, and entrepreneurship, and sports. Distinguished guests, it has always been my belief that wealth creation is pivotal to eradicating poverty. Governments do not create wealth, the private sector does, and therefore innovating to incentivize the private sector to create jobs is the surest way to eradicate poverty. This belief has spurred on my vision to not only help build, but also inspire the next generation of Ghanaian leaders who need right role models to emulate. The vision to create great Ghanaian African business champions, on whose shoulders we will build strong, resilient economies. I can list a lot of the myriad of developed countries who would not have otherwise developed without great champions whose shoulders industries were built. Titans like Henry Ford, JP Morgan, John Rockefeller, and many more literally built the United States of America, and organizations and their organizations have continued to thrive beyond them. This legacy I seek to build here at KGL. Distinguished guests, before I resume my seat, am also delighted to showcase the KGL House as a testament of our dedication to exemplary corporate governance and also a conducive workplace for our team and partners. The KGL House signifies just the beginning of our commitment to ensure the continued success and growth of companies like the KGL Group for generations to come. In closing, I draw inspiration
from one of my favorite hymns, Methodist Hymn 578, which we have got in our lobby, to serve the present age, my calling to fulfill, oh may it all my powers engage to do my master's will. Thank you. God bless our homeland, Ghana, and God bless all of you.
Please don't forget to network, connect, and let's collaborate. Together, we can build our country. Together, we can build Africa. And together, we can conquer the world. Thank you for coming. Let's all continue to be inspired by greatness and enjoy the rest of the evening with some cocktails and some good music from Bam Parade. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more updates.